The exclusion of queer characters in stories and in media for kids has really alarming implications. Queer kids are essentially told during their formative years that they don't or shouldn't exist. And so that's why it was so exciting for me to see in this film a central character be confirmed as queer on screen. This is a big first, and it speaks to the barriers that are being broken.
Katie Mitchell is a 17-year-old girl going to art school, and we all went to art school. And in observing our sort of wonderful weirdo friends that are girls, a lot of them were queer.
I've always felt a little different than everyone else.
Me and my co-writer Jeff are, these cis white bros. And I don't know, can we do this? There was a lot of queer crew members on the movie, and we sat down with them and we said, can we do this? And they're like, yes, do it, of course. What, you have an opportunity, go. We really sort of like held hands with, you know, a bunch of the crew members and said, like, how can we tell this story honestly? And sort of show a gay kid in a theater that they deserve to be the protagonist of their own story.
I relate so much to Katie. As a content creator, you know, Katie uses a lot of her life in her films, and I tend to do that as well. I'm queer, and I came to know it pretty late in life. If I had seen this as a kid, I mean, I don't even know what impact that would have had on me. It's pretty powerful.
California College of Film would love to accept Katie Mitchell
to film school.
To film school.
As we were developing the character more and more, people kept asking, like, Katie seems gay. Is she gay? So it just became something that was like, we felt like we really needed to address.
I remember having a conversation about Katie being queer. Mm. I think I had already been privy to her being queer, like in the thing. I was like, she is though, right?
I've got all these friends to meet. There's this really cool girl, Jade, and we just like all the same stuff, and it's like everyone at the school just gets me.
I was like, oh, I think this character is sort of weirdly coming out to us while we're working on the movie.
As part of the very beginning character design, she's wearing a rainbow pin. It was in there from the beginning, and the question was just about, like, how do we do this in a way that feels honest and true?
We wanted to externalize everything about Katie, like take all of her sort of creative energy and put it on her. So you could see just by looking at her that, like, this is an artist with a lot of ideas and a lot of energy.
I went to art school too and drew almost constantly as a kid. The abundance of drawing pads all over the room.
I'm expressing myself. I want everybody to see me, right? Which is like her whole story in the movie is like, I want my dad to see me.
Yeah.
I want him to see who I really am and love it. And that's what she's saying out in the world.
It felt very authentic and realistic to have this be a holistic part of this creative character.
She draws on her pants, she draws on her body, she's got socks from The Shining.
Yeah.
Like, every part of her is about expressing herself and the things that she likes and her passions.
Well, it's like a signal to other people that they pick up on to say, like, I am of this tribe, do you accept me?
My parents haven't figured me out yet. To be fair, it took me a while to figure myself out.
What really becomes clear, this is how much this is coming from artists.
People felt such a connection to her because she was so specific and because she was like this amalgam of our entire crew who are all sort of weirdo art and film people. Everybody could see themselves in her, and that was what was really cool.
You guys like Robo Slayers 4? No one around here had even heard of that.
Why not? It's amazing.
One of our crew members was like, if I saw this as a little girl, somebody on the screen that looked like me, that would mean so much to me. Maybe if I saw that, I would feel less alone as a kid. And we're like, oh my God, what are we, crazy? We have to do this. Thank you.
Many of us have been working behind the scenes to break down those barriers and to make those stories possible.
It was important that we showed a family positively supportive of Katie and set an example for other parents.
That's my Katie.
Are you eating enough? How's classes? Are you and Jade official, and will you be bringing her home with you for Thanksgiving?
The movie isn't a coming out story. That's not what it's about. This is a character who happens to be gay.
Yeah.
You're not telling a story where their gayness is the plot point.
Yeah.
It's just part of who they are.
Even though there was a story about Rick and Katie, like, not seeing eye to eye, that it was never about her sexuality. They love her. This is the first, like, studio animated protagonist to be gay in a movie, and it's, like, a big deal in some ways, but it shouldn't feel like one. Yes, she's gay, and so what?
Thanks for being the best mom in the world.
We love you, honey.
The more things we make, the more we realize that the audience is down to go basically anywhere with you.
One of our crew members, Lizzie Nichols, she wrote this wonderful email. She said, when I started working in animation, I understood that I would never be able to work on a film with characters that represented who I was. This is a chance we cannot pass up, a chance to have a film represent a part of myself in a community that I assume would always have to be hidden from future animation. We do not want to silence ourselves for fear of a bigoted few. We don't want to cave to their world. We have to be on the side of what is right and just. We just need the backbone to do it. Be that backbone.
Good luck finding your people.
You guys are my people.